Καλησπέρα σε όλους.
Γεια σας. Και πρώτα απ' όλα θα ήθελα να σας καλωσορίσω στη Στέγη, γραμμάτων και τεχνών του Ιδρύματος Ονάση.
Ποιοι θα τα κάνουν όλα αυτά, τυπάδες σαν και αυτούς που βλέπετε στην εικόνα. Όχι οι κλασικοί rockstars που ξέρουμε, αλλά ένα πολυσύνθετη ομάδα από επιστήμονες, οι οποίοι έχουν ρομαντισμό και ρομαντισμό. Προκειμένου βλέπετε τον Χρήστο Παπαδημητρίου, εμένα, και αρκετούς από τους διδακτορικούς μου φοιτητές, σε ένα, όλοι μαζί είμαστε πέρυσι στο Berkeley για ένα ειδικό εξάμεινο στην αλγοριθμική θεωρία παιχνίων. Και μετά από όλα αυτά, θα ήθελα να σας ευχαριστήσω για την προσοχή σας και ελπίζω να βγάλατε κάτι από την παρουσίαση.
Here's what I would like to hear on top of that. First encounter with computing. How was knowledge disseminated at that period? Because like information theory was a young field and it already reached Greece. So it's interesting to hear. Right? It was not like today. So.
Right. Yeah. So control theory, information theory. These subjects I liked. But I saw them as very interesting flashes in the distant horizon that showed me that there is light somewhere. Okay, you know. So I think that since then I was longing to understand computation. They were taught to us. By frankly mediocre professors. I remember looking at my professors throughout my studies and thinking I'm about 10 times smarter than this guy, but of course I will never become a professor. You know, that it was the way one grew up in Greece then. Okay.
It's because of the regime or because of the hierarchy?
It was because of the regime, because I was, to become anything, you have to have witness that you belong to the right. You know. So professorships were essentially hereditary, usually through the son-in-law. Okay, you know. So it was like a corrupt to the bone thing. Okay, so I'm jumping now several decades ahead to understand what was the academic situation in Greece at that time. In the late 1970s. That university elected me as professor, and I was about to go back to leave my job at MIT and go back and teach. I was consulting at Bell Labs, and at some point I went late for lunch, and an old man came and sat next to me, and I said, "Oh my God, that's Erdős Pál, that's Erdős," he told me, he said, "You are at MIT now?" And I told him, yes, but I'm thinking of going back and teaching Greece. And then he nodded his head, he ate his lunch, and then he asked me, "Which university are you going to in Greece? The one that kicked out Papagyriakopoulos or the one that kicked out Karatheodori?" Okay, so basically, the two greatest mathematicians of the 20th century had returned to Greece. And for various reasons, political reasons in both cases, Papakyriakopoulos was a friend of the liberal leader of the time, Venizelos. Very very important Greek politician, but on the anti-royal Republican side. And Papakiriakopoulos was one of the greatest topologists of 20th century, who was chased away for political reasons, you know, because he was on the left and went to Princeton, where he he didn't teach, but he was a professor for a long time. Yeah, so, it turns out that I ended up being chased away from Greece also, not exactly for political reasons, for political in a much more mundane sense. It was too early for computer science in Greece. Okay, so yeah.
Let's go back to the 60s. And then the first encounter with the. With the computer,
right.
And then we look chronologically through the 70s, and then
probably the best thing that happened to me in that university, because I did not like the subjects. I finished something like 10th or 20th in my class. Okay, so you know, I was, you know, I could not do worse, you know, but I did as badly as I could, I did not attend any classes, I studied for a weekend before the exams and so on, you know, I was doing other things. That university gave my first encounter with the computer. It was IBM 1640, I believe. I'm pretty sure that's the model number. It was a huge room, but I befriended the operators, and once in a while I would slip them a deck of cards and get a printout. Okay, when I was in the third year of school. I was obsessed with the distribution of primes, and I discovered the prime number theorem. I provided a heuristic proof, that the distribution is 1/log n. I wrote a heuristic differential equation. I ended up publishing it because I put it as an exercise in my complexity book. Okay, you know, I went to all mathematicians in my university and told them about this interesting fact that I discovered, and none of them knew the prime number theorem.
How did you come about?
I went to the library, I picked up the text in number theory, and so, you know, in chapter 4 it was the prime number theory. Okay, when I say library, I did not have a library, you know, so I did not have access to it, and my school's library was terrible shape. It was very poor, but there was the American Library, I would get all my scientific information from it. I mean, it was, I assume, a very mediocre library, but it was better library than I had. Before I first met the computer, the very few people who understood that I was good in math and science, they were telling me, you know, your destiny is to become a nuclear scientist. I was paying attention to physics. I had sort of internalized it a little, but when I saw the computer. When I saw that huge room with blinking lights, when I realized that I can learn this new language. Okay, so you know it. It really impressed me. It was basically. I remember telling my friends who had never heard of that. It's a language where you have to explain everything. I mean, you have to explain details that you didn't know exist. Okay, imagine you are telling a story. Okay, sort of, you know, but I mean, this person has never lived. Okay, you know, you say, and they ask you floors. I mean, you have, what is a floor? Okay, you know, you know, you cannot. You have to explain everything with precise detail. And then my friends will say, I mean, but isn't this annoying? I said, yeah, but you understand the story much better, so much better, you know. So, so I knew. I mean, I think, you know, Don Knuth says that our tribe existed forever, okay, but. Who knows what kind of mind games we played? Okay, before the computer. Okay, we have been waiting for thousands of years for the computer to be invented. Okay, and I think that some of us are basically born to be that, and we are lucky that we were not born 100 years ago. Okay, so that's it was the most primitive computer you can imagine. If you believe that it was a decimal computer, okay, so every 4 bits, it was a decimal number. Of course, I learned Fortran because that's perennial language. Yeah, it was the only fascination I had, you know, the only fascination I had with science and intellect those days. Okay, so you know, I was into essentially partying, gambling, other things. Okay, so
tell me about the gambling and the partying.
Really?
Yes.
Are you sure? So
yes,
so
yes.
So you know, I right after my father died, I spent a year. So you know, completely dropping out. I was staying with two other gamblers, and sort of, you know, we would wake up, start with backgammon, go on to canasta, sort of kumkan, another, you know, and then end up with poker, you know. So that's, you know, there are many things I regretted in my life. This was an exciting, you know, this was an exciting year. Okay, you know, so that's it was also the richest year of my life. You know, I made more money than that. So,
so what made you quit?
Okay, you want to hear that story? Okay, so. When I finished my university,